I work on the Connect for Climate program of the World Bank Group. It's a global partnership program, and we have now 250 partners from all over the world, from different organizations, international organizations, academia, think tanks, as well as the private sector, all coming together to take on climate change. It's a communications initiative, which means we all work together to produce a lot of high-impact communication outreach activities.
Okay, and part of that is a video competition at this COP, is that right? Tell me a bit about that.
Yeah, so we engage with influential industries, from the fashion industry to the sports industry, as well as the film industry, and we work a lot with youth and social media to get the voices and messages out. We also work with celebrities and influential leaders from the private sector, as well as these influential industries. And our big focus over the last year has actually been the film industry. Donald will tell us a bit more about that, but some of the engagement components within working with film is that we've been running a lot of youth contests. And our latest one was actually called Film a Day for Climate Action, which happened on the 29th of November, the day of mass mobilization around the world. And basically we partnered with Vimeo to aggregate stories from that day, from people in the marches, from people building their solutions and talking about climate change and telling the world leaders what they want to happen here at COP21.
Okay, and Donald, you've been involved in the creative side. What kind of stories did we see?
Well, we first of all started a competition for shorts on climate change from all over the world, and we were able to put together a jury that was, the president was Bernardo Bertolucci. It included Wim Wenders, Pablo Trapiero, Fernando Meirelles, Walter Salles, Mira Nair, Bob Rafelson, Mark Forster, Atom Egoyan, and Mika Charismaki. I think
that's quite a lineup.
That's not bad. That was sort of the beginning, and then we gave some cash money to these awards. We had about 300 shorts that came in, so it was quite intensive. And I think it's been an interesting process because the filmmakers have become much more involved and much more aware of the climate issue, and so they've been helping us to, and they, you know, we've kind of informed them, but they've been helping us to transmit it in a, not as if it's a moral thing, but you know, a genuine interest on their part, which has been a huge success. And now we managed over the year that started in Guadalajara Film Festival, a charter that has been signed by the film studios, well, by the PGA that represents the film studios, and Ecoprod, which is a big European organization, and many other trade unions and individual filmmakers that will commit to reducing the carbon footprint of individual productions.
Okay, that's great. And what next for your communications program, Max?
Sure. So one of the main reasons why we're here is to help elevate the voices of young people. So early in November, we launched what was a social media campaign, Youth for Climate was the hashtag. It was with the support of NOAA, Department of Energy, the White House, Earth Day Network, and a bunch of others. And it culminated really with the Youth Day yesterday here at the COP, where we worked directly with the UNFCCC to help organize the intergenerational panel on bringing young voices and leader voices. So Cristiana Figueres was there. And last night we also had a great panel discussion with Kumi Naidu, Bianca Jagger, Fernando Meirelles, one of the filmmakers, and Slater Jewel Kemke, who showed a trailer of her newest production, An Inconvenient Youth.
Great, so lots going on. And is there anything that people can catch in the next week of the conference?
Actually, tonight, so we'll be speaking at a side event at 6:30 on non-conventional educational methods. And then this evening is the youth reception right here at the Climate Change Studio, which we're putting on with the UNFCCC and Earth Day Network and a bunch of other partners. And we want everybody there. We'll be showing some of the Day for Climate videos, and we'll be celebrating youth voices from around the world.
And I think, I think think you should mention the website, www.connectforclimate.org, where you will find all the different ramifications of the program and keep in touch with everything and send us things.
Okay, great.